I don't have the microphone, so it's better with the microphone. But so tonight we have two speakers on you, Gilles. You will do a great job as a facilitator. So welcome the web to watch us tonight.
Okay, thank you. Good evening, everybody, to Type Paris 2016, I think so. I'm really happy to introduce for the first talk Helena Ichbiah from Ich&Kar studio. Please come. So Helena is a graphic designer, and she's very well known for a prolific graphic production in the luxury design, hotel, restaurants. She and Piotr, our associates, work together for 25 years now, I think so. And they continue to work now overseas because they work in the United States, in New York, in Los Angeles, and they do a really great job. So please applause Helena, and the night's up to you.
Hello. Yeah. So we are a small studio in Montreuil. So we work in our house. I like to show our house because people think we have a big office with many places, but it's like really in our house. So you come through the kitchen, you go up the stairs, and here is our big mess. That's how we work. We have a lot of collections. We collect hands and a lot of stuff. So it's not like a web cafe. It's like a real place. And the main collection we have is a book collection. So this is just one part. We have a collection of more of 1,000 dictionaries, and it's too heavy. So because we are small, we work with two or three persons. Here we have two assistants who are present in the here, and we don't work for big corporations. We work for I would say, as Tibor Kalman said, for a few lunatics, for a few people who mind about creativity and who share with us the envy of doing something different. So I choose the few projects, very different projects, but so to show you. So I tried to find projects with some typography, because we are more graphic designers than typographer. So I would say typography is one of our tools, but it's not the only one. And actually, my assistant could tell you that I hate when it looks like graphic design. I really want it to look like it hasn't been done like from a printer, or it has been done like that. Not. I don't like it when it's too graphic. So the first client I want to talk to you about is a tools gallery. So it's Loic Bigot, and he has a gallery with who is exhibiting design pieces. So for a gallery that is exhibiting design pieces, when you go to the show, you see usually three or four pieces. And before, when I met him, I was receiving his invitations. And there was always a picture of one piece and the text of the invitation behind. So I really had the feeling that you didn't have to go to the exhibition because you had seen the piece. So I found it, or you could say, oh, I went, but you didn't have to go because you saw it on the picture. So we talked about it, and I made him a proposition that it won't be a picture anymore, but we would like try to do invitation that would just like would be a continuation of the design that he was exhibiting. So these are the invitations. So for example, this is an exhibition by Yona Vautrin, and she did these lamps. So it was just like maybe 8 to 12 pieces exhibited, and the invitation was like that. So very simple, just a close-up of the pattern of the lamp, and also I try every time to use the materials. For example, it's the lamp. It's anodized, so we used like a blue anodized. This exhibition was knock on wood. So what this was different designers who were playing about wood. So I found this fabulous paper, and we burnt it to have a nice invitation. But it's a paper that is really just looking like wood, and it was like really cool to find it. This was an exhibition by Guillaume Delving, Relief, and it's one piece of what he was shown, but at the time the exhibition was to be mounted, they just gave me this photo. So I tried to express this relief. So I used carton ondulé, I don't know. And I made it comment tu dis, enfoncé. Quoi? I made an embossing, but it was like really hard because I wanted to be really flat. So the guy did it, but he said he's never going to do it again. That often our works, when we ask for things, the people say yes, okay, we do it, but then they don't want to do it. So it's always a one trial. This one was a terrazzo project by some Swiss guy. We will see the name just later. And it was like really nice because it's cement with glass. So I tried to have this feeling. So here you cannot really see it, but you have the feeling. But because we used the blue transparent plastic that was like thick, and we did like some screen printing on it. So this was an exhibition about pieces that are mechanical pieces and who are playing with the light. So we did something very between day and night. So this one I liked especially because it was like the exhibition was called Distorted, and she was playing with tangram mirrors and distorted furniture. And we distorted the paper and screen. We folded the paper before the screen printing and made the screen printing once the paper was folded. So this again was a hard one. This was one for Ettore Sotsas. They had these Japanese pieces with red lacquer and black, which were very precious. And it was like a joint venture between Tools Gallery and another gallery. So they gave us some of the writing of Ettore Sotsas. So we scanned it to make the Tools Gallery written by Ettore Sotsas. And then we used the black and the red lacquer to be like really near the pieces. This one is Laurent Massalou, and it's called the double exhibition. So we wanted to have like the same feeling of something that is folded and all folded. So that's it. So for this kind of job, I really, when I search for a typography, I really search more like a feeling to express what the design wants to say. And it doesn't have to be a real great type. It just has to reflect the feeling of the exhibition. This is another work we did. Sometimes we work with friends, and but he's not a friend anymore. But okay, he was a friend. He was. Sometimes we work with clients and they become friends. Sometimes you work with friends and then you're not friends anymore, and then you're friends again. So maybe we will be friends again, but. But we did a great, at that time we did a great thing which I'm really proud, and it was really nice to work with Jean Réal. So he's a bibliophile, I don't know how to say. And he has a great collection of books, and he's really into literature, and he loves animals. And he compiled a quotation about animals. So it's his own choice about quotation of animals, and he said, he proposed me to do a book. But he wanted us to be a co-author, which is not really very fluent, very, which usually the graphic designer is just like at the end of the book. But he really wanted us to be, to have our name on the book at the same stage as him. So I was really impressed. So I said, oh, we have to work a lot, maybe. So we did some latrines for every animal. So it was like, how you say, it was like a school exercise. We chose the character Bodoni, and we tried to design animals with all the glyphs that Bononi would give. So it was really a fun thing to do. So that's how it looked in the book. So this was for the enter, for entering a letter. And then we did like some small animation to promote the book. So it was really, we had a lot of fun with that. And this one is the last one I brought, but I really like this one specially. So, then this is Christophe, is a, comment tu dis, argentier? Silver, silver quoi. Bon, je sais pas. Okay, so Christophe, there's Stéphane Parmentier, who is art director of Christophe. And he really loves graphic design, and he really tried to find a subject to work with us because he wanted to bring some graphic design on silverware. So he thought about the timbales that you offer for when a child is born, and usually you offer to the child a timbal with his monogram. So he asked us to design a new and a more modern alphabet to do this silverware. So we thought about what special we could bring, because there are so many very nice alphabets, and actually I love timbals with very normal classical letters. So we tried to find more like about the concept about what is when a child is born. So either he's the son of your life. So we designed an alphabet we called son. So so to be engraved on the timbals. But then they thought it could be also nice on a small necklace. So we had to do two sizes for each letter, because engravery was a technique, it could not be this one in smaller. So I give you a small. So this is how it looks like on the necklaces. And this is how it looks like on the timbals. So for me, it's more like illustrations than typography, I guess. So the second one is more illustration, because I thought, okay, in this period, what is the second thing that what a kid is for you? So it's a king. So we designed an alphabet with crowns, so so that every little child could have his crown. So the same. We did in small and in big. And this is how it looks like on the timbal. Designer box. So designer box, it's a totally different subject. Designer box is a startup. And I'm sure you know a box. There are makeup boxes, there are shoe boxes, socket boxes. So the system is you. Comment dit abonnement. You subscribe for a box for 3 months or 1 year, and you receive a present in your box. And for them, it was you would receive a design piece. So they asked me to design the logo. So you know, with those startups, they have a brand, a sur brand. So this is the sur brand, and then designer box. So it's just like a box in the logo, very simple. But the idea was to have like a wooden box, which would be very nice and when you received it, and that the box would be also an object. And I have to say, I'm a box collector myself. And often when I have shoe boxes, I really love them. But you know what I hate is the logo on the shoe box, because it put it all. It cannot be a box on my office, so I have to put a sticker on it. But sometimes the boxes are so nice and you want to keep it. And so I told them, okay, we are doing this because you want people to collect design. So, and you want them also to collect your boxes. And it's like, really, you want to see, I have the box 3 and the box 2. So I told them, we are not going to put the logo on the box. or in very small. So I proposed to, so it would not be, so the logo is very small here, the two logos of the two brands. And it's the number of the box you get that is making actually the brand. So it's actually very nice because you receive a box with a nice number, and I kind of find it funny because we gave them maybe 30 or 40 numbers, and I love how the numbers they go well with the design piece, and it was not designed after the design piece, it was done before. But when I look, I think really, for me, the five is really elegant with this. So, and the box 21 was ours. So they asked us to design the box. So they asked us to design, they asked us to design plates for the for Valentine's Day, because it was a February box. So we thought forever, how you say infini, eternity, no, je sais pas. So because it was us, we redesigned our number, and we designed these plates. When they are together, they make this eternity sign, and there was also a magazine, and this is how it looks like with a beautiful cake, with a logo by Jean-François Porchette. So the idea is that the boxes, you use them at home, and it's really nice to have these numbers because you know that you have your checkbooks in the one and your bracelets in the seven. The other thing we did, because it's like really a startup on internet, so we had to give them a language, how to speak. So we designed this little vignette, and this is how they can be used. This is something we did, but this is something they are doing alone, and I'm really happy because they are. It's usually many times when we design an identity, it's like a toolbox. We give to our clients the tools so they can do by themselves. So I'm happy when the tools are working well. So we are working a lot for the food business, the food industry. And it started with restaurants. But this is one of the last restaurants we did. It's Cadet. It's located in LA. I don't have the picture of my client, I'm really sorry. It was so small on internet and I couldn't get him. So, and so this guy, it was really funny because he called us, at the office. And you know, we have many friends who are making fun of us and making jokes on the phone. So I thought it was a joke because he said, "Are you Ich&Kar?" I said, "Yes, yes." And the guy said, "You must be so proud of your work." So what do you say to that? Because you heard, I was sure it was a friend. I said, "No, we don't have time for that. We work." So this is in LA, and this is like in the middle. It was a place where the restaurant is going to was. So this is like the interior, like American trendy kind of like European, when Americans want to look like Europeans. So this was the logo we designed. I love this logo because I think it's like a bad logo. But it's really what I wanted. I want it to be like something that when if you are in Montmartre and you think there were Picasso and Matisse and they had a friend that who had a bar and said, can you design me a logo? And they would just like write it like that. And I really want to have this feeling of not really well done and with like some accidents. So these are the business cards. We work a lot for restaurants, and I think in a restaurant there are so many things that are important. The menu is one, but it's like really a tiny one. But what I like is when all the graphic design is part of the play, because I really think when you go in a restaurant, it's like a ballet. Everyone is playing his role, and actually the graphic identity has also its role to play. So in the same mood, we designed something for the back of the business card. And this is the menu. It's like big playing cards. And they are in a little pocket. So when you hold the menu, it's like you are playing cards. So we designed all these little titles and tried to have something very like laid back. So it gives a menu like that. So here you have the pocket in real. And this photo is like horrible, but I love it because it's really when the people, when they are holding the menu, they become like actors of my play. And you know what I love is like, what my clients love is when we design menus, there are always big stars on Instagram. People love to make the photos with the so that's a cool thing. So this is when you get the quote. So the bill. So the bill is in a little pocket, and here you have the business card, and you can put your American Express very discreetly. It's all about the gesture. And this is when you want to offer a diner to a friend. It's like a voucher for the restaurant. This one I love because we wanted to do like Chinese good luck, lucky charms. So we found a few quotes about alcohol, a waltz and a glass of wine invites an encore. And we put them in some stirrers, in glass stirrers. So it's really nice because when you get your cocktail, you have a nice little message about drinking more and more and more. An invite. This is another client, and he comes before the name because he has a lot of restaurants, so I work a whole lot with him. And I like that because you will see we do very different stories together. So the first restaurant I will talk about is a sketch in London. So the sketch by itself, it's a few restaurants, because it's like Alice in Wonderland. So for the sketch in general, this is a logo, but you will see it nowhere. Just on some letterheads and the business cards, but this business card, it's not the business cards of the restaurant, it's the business cards for the when you meet someone to do your other flowers. So this is one of the restaurants. It's the gallery. Actually, the decor is changing every 2 or 3 years. So this, it's pink, yes. Yeah, but it's pink because of my menu, because my menu is older than this decor. So you will see. But this menu actually is black, and I really like this menu. I don't have really nice pictures of enough pictures of this menu. But when the menu is closed, it's really a black folder, and when you open it, the forks are coming up. So it's quite a nice display. So then there is this other place in the same sketch, which is called the Parlor. So here is my menu. It's really part of the decor. Here you see it from here. So here there are many menus. And here we are coming. So I told them it would be nice to have like in this kind of decor to have like old books, a selection of old books. And it's like, and I wanted the menu to look like, you know, like an old advertisement that you would receive by, and you would, comme un très grand marque-page. So this was the intention of the books. So we played. We are playing a lot with old vignettes, old vignettes, in a funny way. For example, I love this one because this is for the signature cake. So every cake has its balance. So after the cake, you have to do some bicycle. So here you have the wine, so every wine. And here you are the cocktails, and you have the fight between the sketch exclusive and the classic, so choose your weapon. The Glade has the same kind of menu, but in green. So they just change the paper, but they print the same. The Parlor, we just say before, we can be, it's like in London. So when you want to go in the day, it's an open place, but in the night, it's a club, and you have to become a member. So this is all the material to become a member and explaining. This is a close-up of the voucher box of the sketch. Actually, this one I'm actually very proud of because I, you know, the restaurants, they always want to have a voucher. And sometimes I think, when you go to a party and you bring just a postcard with a voucher for a restaurant, it's not really something. You prefer to bring flowers because it's bigger. So I propose them, okay, they would spend a lot more money than a postcard, but we will do a light box with different things inside. So when you bring a present, a voucher, you really bring a present. So you have this card where you can write your friend's name, and then you have this this little envelope with little postcards of every place in the sketch, and always with a little story to explain you that it's the best present to bring. Why I'm very proud of it, because it worked. So they were selling like 20 vouchers a year, and now they are selling more than 500 vouchers a year. And even if this costs to the client, because the client pays for the box now. So it's really a cool thing to think that sometimes thinking at a box brings some success. So these are the bags when you buy a cake at the sketch, you come back with a bag like that. And for every everything that we do at the sketch, we write a new story. I always like to say I don't like lazy design. So for me, like an identity, it's like the beginning of a story, and the story that that is never ending. So this is a small bag. This is a big bag. So since it's as I said, a very Alice in Wonderland place. We are writing stories that are also a little surrealistic, speaking of people with no problems, who play bridge, and to have the time to go eat a cake and thinking of their granddaughter who's climbing the Himalaya. It's really, we try to describe a funny world. So we did also some tea towels for them. So always with nice stories. So Le Derriere is another restaurant of Mourad, a restaurant in Paris. And this restaurant is, it's behind two restaurants he also has. Well, so when he asked me how to call it, I said, call it behind. So it's called Le Derriere. So this is his visual identity. So we use a lot of definition and dictionary identity. So we changed, and well, the menu are folded so that inside the hidden there is a stomach, the list of all the Arabs of all near where Mourad come from. So you have all the phone numbers of his family. And the menu is like quite disturbing, because you just have to read the, if you just want to eat, you just have to eat the black. The other is just for decor, so it's just like the plain definition. So it can disgust you from what you were going to eat, because we are just taking them from the dictionary. So sometimes it's not very, it's not always very, very cool. So the Andy Walu is another story. So it's this bar. So it's just before the Derriere. So before, it was not like that. Before it was much more pop. It was also called Andy Walu. And we did the visual identity. And Mourad came to Paris because he's living in London. And he was like thinking, there are only 20 years old people in my bar. And I'm 50. I want to have my friend in that bar. We have to change it and make it a bar for older people. So I look at him and I said, no, I don't want to redo a menu of alcohols, because this is really not nice to do. So he says, yes, but look, it's going to be a bar for people from 35 with a big, big alcohol list, big, big whiskey list. I said, oh, no. But these guys are very, very open-minded. So since I really didn't want, I find an idea to making me want doing this menu. So, well, this is another, I will talk about this later maybe. So this is Mr. Andy Walu. And I proposed him to do a book, and I proposed him to hire a writer to write stories about, so Andy Walu, you have to know, in Arab it means I have nothing. Andy is I have nothing. So if you ask for, have you have a cigarette, Andy Walu. So, and it was really funny, because it's like so near Andy Warhol. So we thought it was like the loser of Andy Warhol, kind of. The Arab Andy Warhol. So we thought this guy should have a story, and I imagined that that he was the guy who served the alcohol in Shining, and I chose the first author was Jean Réal. I chose the guy with whom I did the animals. At the end of this book, we were not friends anymore. So I asked him. I told him, okay, Look, what I know about Andy is that this guy has partied a lot. He has partied all around the world. He had made the best concert, the worst parties. He threw up with Madonna. And this is what I know. What do you know about him? And write me 16 stories. So he wrote me 16 stories about Andy. And so this is a cocktail. So this is a story. And at the end, you have the alcohol. But when there weren't menus anymore, I thought it was like too bad to reprint. So I thought, okay, we use another writer, and we hire another writer to do another book with other stories. So this is the second book. So it works really well, because in this bar, when you look at the menu, you look like really very, very smart. And this was the second party for the second book. Avec un petit, with a special dedicate. Okay. C'est bon? Ça fait une heure? Ou j'étais trop vite? So I can show more. You want? Okay, I was supposed to finish here. But I have... So I have some other projects to show, but this is, for example, the visual identity we did for BETC. This was funny because I thought this is like the biggest agency in Paris, so they have to have their logo in neon. So I loved the typography of the pharmacy in Paris. So I thought they have to have the same. So I found that the Prisma was a perfect type for an advertising company. And I tried to do it thinner, but as I'm not a typographer, I searched and searched, and I thought there must be someone who worked on that. And I found those guys in Switzerland. Oh, fuck, I'm too bad. I don't remember. They designed the Prisma set. But it was not finished. So I made BETC wait 1 year so they could finish to have all these letters. I was really proud. So they can decline it. And we played with this... little bee. So for example, in the different pages of the blog, the bee is like flying. It's never on the same page. So we did all the materials that an advertising agency needs. So this is for their presentations. This is with a wrapper's USB. This is Annabelle Karim-Kassar. She's a cosmopolitan architect, I would say. She's living between London, Lebanon, and Dubai. And she asked us to design her logo and her visual identity, but at the beginning she really wanted a website. We made different propositions, and she really chose this one. But the funny thing with this also, we just designed the letters of Annabelle. So I'm not prepared for this. You have these little strokes. So we thought it could be nice to play with these strokes to give the images a feeling of the typography. So this is how it works. I love that. We did it with a little program. It was like really funny. So what's funny about this logo is that it's reversible. So you can, when the card is full, it's reversible. So we did a lot of postcards to explain her her travels and her universe. This is a close-up of a folder. Alors là j'ai... Okay, there was one image has nothing to do. So this is a folder. And she wanted also to have like little notebooks to give her to her clients. So we played with the little strokes to do like different patterns on the playing page. So one page of concrete is here. This is another logo. It's another identity for a small company who is working with concrete. So we wanted to bring this this feeling of something really strong that is also very so design. So this is how the logo looks like when it's in on the concrete. So we designed different letters so you could also have this like feeling of a landscape. This is a page of their catalog. And this is when you want to write Happy New Year. So every time we want to write, you have to, when we don't have the, it's always a question of like a wind, like a landscape. And this is a project I did with them before doing their visual identity. It was for Biennale de Saint-Étienne. We were in a group called Particule 14, and we were invited to do to imagine a work with different companies. So I was with concrete with these guys, and I did this wall, which I called the Jubilation Wall. So it's a laughing wall with. With ha 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 hee hee. So with different panels. And this is some wallpaper we do. We are actually I have to say that I was very quick, so this was it's not sorted at the end. So sorry. So this is wallpaper because we have like a design activity, so we designed loft wallpaper. My kids hate it because they thought it's not a nice present for a kid to receive this on Christmas. They ask us to stop. But actually the parents, they love it because they're sure because these are actually our best sellers. And this is a nice exhibition we did with my friend Clémence Farrell. She's a scenographer, and when we work together, we really work as a team. So we called it scenographisme because it's not just the scenography before and then the graphic design. So this was a poster we did for the exhibit, and when you entered, it was like all the films that. Would be showed in the exhibit. And what I really liked in this exhibition is these are the cartels. On dit cartel? The comment on dit cartel? Usually, you know, when you have a look. Je sais pas comment on dit. The takers? The titles usually are really small, you know, with a photo next to the photo. And I thought, you know, these titles, they should be... Non, c'était sûr que c'est cartel. Les cartels d'une exposition, je ne sais pas comment on dit. The little boards, you know. And I told them, look, this... Caption. And I really wanted them to be big. So usually this should be like this, you know, where you read what the image is. But I thought actually the name dropping is much more than the photos. Because, for example, I don't know Miklos Rosa, but I know Ben-Hur. And because I love Ben-Hur, I'm going to be interested in the photo. So I told them that we had to have like really big, big captions, if it's called like that. And it was like a really nice experience, because actually the text was brought to a new level. And this is one to finish. It's like for a wedding. So it was a wedding with they would do a bal masqué. So you had to be disguised. So it was like a folded thing where you can have different. So voilà. Et voilà.
Thank you, Helena. Is there some questions following this presentation? No? Not for the moment. So maybe the first one.
François has a question.
You do a lot of identity for restaurants. Do you select the restaurant because of the quality of their drinks or food or not? Do you test the food to say yes to a project or not?
Yeah, actually, I test the people before.
Ah, you test the people.
It's yeah. Like, no, it's not really about... usually, when the people are good, they will do good food. Ah. But for example, a few... I won't say when. We did a logotype for a hotel, but then we didn't do the identity because it was too hard.
Because of the people or because you
because of the
bed?
People, I think, you know, when you work, it's really important, the feeling and the relationship. And I prefer to stop work than having a bad relationship, because I give too much to my work of my life. So it has to be pleasant. So if it's unpleasant, I prefer to stop. So there are different ways to stop. You can stop hard, you can stop like slow, not calling back, never calling back. So at the end, they understand. So when I have the time and the energy, I stop strong. And when I don't have, I stop. But usually, we are better choosers. So when you immediately feel if you can work with someone or not, if he has a good energy. And actually, it's true, we have a lot of clients that we work a long time now. So I have to say they are well educated.
You mentioned that your assistant or someone said, I hate when it looks too much like graphic design. I agree, in a way. I'm a graphic designer, but I think many graphic designers do just mainstream things that look like the graphic designer is here, and we notice he's here. And you also mentioned that you enjoyed doing something for the Cadere restaurant in LA that had some imperfection flaws. So could you elaborate on those two points of view, points of your philosophy?
For example, there are like some fashions in typography. I don't like what I don't like. Comment s'appelle la typo que je déteste? Gotham. For example, Gotham, I will never use Gotham. It's for me, it's too graphic design, you know. When you see something in Gotham, it's like, ooh. For me, it looks like, so it's more like, and sometimes, you know, when it's, you know, I really love old books, and sometimes in old books you have like advertising, and it's the imperfections are so nice, and it's like, and you know, before you didn't have the computer, and you didn't have like so many buttons to touch, so for example, it's really funny because when we did this one. I have an assistant who just came, and he did like really, he wanted to do big spacing, and I said, no, don't touch all the buttons. Because when he, you know, I wanted to, you type it and it's nice like it's typed. You don't do, I shouldn't say that here. You don't do the work, because sometimes when you do the work and it's too perfect, for me then it looks like a bank. And it or an insurance, and I like when it's I like when the design is violent, when it gives you a, and sometimes when I learned the graphic design, there was no computer, so I'm really a dinosaur. So I had a computer the first year I worked, but we didn't have time to see all that, and actually. Many times when I think something is too designed, for example, when the letters are really so nicely spaced, I feel like you feel too much the designer, and I feel like in Gattaca, you know, like in the world, like Bienvenue à Gattaca in the next century, you know, where everything is transparent and the letters are spaced. So I like it sometimes when, so it was funny because he just arrived and he wanted to do good. So, and I made a capture of my screen, and I put like red on everything he couldn't touch. I said, don't touch, right. So this is the first one. And then for Cadet, Jean-Charles, who did all the writings, you can he can tell you that he had a hard time with me, because when it was too, I wanted to look like a girl is really laid back, and sometimes it was like I said, oh, and it was really a start of the. It's really hard to find the feeling. It's well done, but it's not well done, you know? It's really the, it's like in a mood, and maybe it's just my mood. Sometimes I must say, okay, no, let it go, but it's really a question of, it's hard to do, because we are not typographers. So it's hard for us to design letters just for titles, just for fun, and having this feeling that it's like really, we didn't want it to look like lettering, but we didn't want it to look like someone that has written it like this. So it had to be like some kind of dexterity, but cool. I don't know if I respond well.
And another question? No?
No.
Your clients seems really important in your work. You introduce each case study with a portrait of the...
Yes, but I think it's really important because you work with people.
I know. I think it's the main thing to deal in a design. But how do you... How do you manage the concept? There are some original ideas and more related to the text. In fact, you want a transparent typographic in your design, but the text is
We rewrite a lot. Actually, For my clients, I'm not a graphic designer. I don't know what I am. I'm everything. Because I have small clients, you know, they don't have the opportunity. We don't work as an agency. We don't have. It's not like they have a copywriter. So often they write themselves their text, or the text is written by someone. But as you work, the text is so important because it's what you have to express in graphic design. And a bad text actually is really hard to lay out. You cannot lay out a bad text. It doesn't come. So sometimes when for my layout it's missing a word, I put a word more. And when there is a word too much, I put a word off if it doesn't change the... But I think the way we work, we're really working on ideas, on concept, and on the copywriting also.
And your type font choosing is really quick. It's more related more families, or you take care of that, or it's
so as I
rough.
As I learned on books, and you had to choose your character and paste and cut and paste them. Before you choose, you had to be very sure. So I'm kind of fond of characters, but I couldn't say it. I couldn't tell you any name of the character I use because I'm an Alzheimer font girl. So, but. So I have families that I love. I use a lot of Avenir, I use a lot of Johnston, I use a lot of... I love Parisian. They have some fonts that really come back, that are my... my balance, my palette. And then I have assistants who love fonts. And they bring me and they show me. There was this guy, he really wanted me to use Gotham. And he tried, each time he put Gotham. And then finally he got me on one. So I said, OK. So I have one Gotham work. But no, I love, you know, now on the websites, you can choose with moods, you can choose with, you know, when you go on my fonts, you can choose 30s, and you look a lot of types, and then I really, I look what I search, and then I receive newsletters of font shops, and I buy when I find a character that I really like. I bought a PS Fournier, Total. I love it. We used it. So when we buy a font, then we use it because we have to make it worse, the buy. But no, it's. I think we have. I have. We have a special relationship with the typography because we didn't have so much. I studied 3 years. At that time, you studied 3 years, so. Maybe I had 2 years of typography, and it was not like I didn't have maybe the best. So I'm not really, but I have many old books about typography. So I'm really amateur, like an amateur.
But it's a quality. One more question.
So you have worked with lots of small clients, but also for BTC design, a BTC agency as one of the biggest one. So I wonder if there was some difference between work for the big agency and the small clients, and which one you prefer? Thank you.
I cannot really say that because it's I knew Remy from very long time from a long time ago, and when I met him they were 80, they were not 900 like today. So when he asked me to redo his visual identity, you know, I met two people. So for me, it's like, and I never, actually, I never think, I'm just thinking, oh, because there are 900 people, it's much more people who are going to use it, so it's gonna be a bigger budget maybe. So this is, no, I don't feel really the difference, because the difference between, it's always people, and I think, it would have been different if we were working with a marketing, if he would have asked a marketing director to work with us and then to show him. But actually we worked directly with Remy on his, on Xiberas. So it was like, actually what I want is to have the work with the designers. So this is the limit of, our business. You cannot work with Air France because they are working with a lot of people who work with a lot of people, and I don't have this company. So we work with people who are our mirror, in, for instance.
Helena, what is good with your the end of your presentation, when you explain that you are not good at typography and you are typo lover, you are the perfect person for this kind of conference because you say, I'm bad, but everything you show it's perfect, it's good. And you are really the typical graphic designer who are fall in love with typography.
Yeah.
So thank you very much.
Thank
it's
you.
Very nice for type designer.
Thank you.